Welcome to my new video, which is gonna be about top 10 science-based ingredients which shouldn't be missing in your shampoo. So make notes carefully. This video is gonna be a little more extensive. You are watching Matt Dominant's hair transplant channel, where we want to stop hair loss forever and have a healthy hair for the rest of our lives. Let's start. Let's just start with the number 10 right now, which is gonna be rosemary oil or rosemary extract. Rosemary oil is very well known for its anti-inflammatory benefits and it improves the circulation on your scalp. There's one study that compared rosemary oil to minoxidil, the FDA approved solution for hair loss. So what were the results? Both groups experienced a significant increase in hair count at the 6 month endpoint compared to the baseline. At the end, there was no better result from the rosemary or minoxidil. However, both groups experienced some hair regrowth. The group who applied minoxidil actually experienced more scalp itching. Number 9 is gonna be coconut oil, and it was compared to many other oils, and it was found as the best one to reduce the protein loss remarkably for both undamaged and damaged hair when used as a pre-wash and post-wash grooming product. So, as you know, your hair is made of protein. So what coconut oil does, basically it acts as a protein preservant at the end. So this is great if you wanna have a healthy hair. Number 8 is gonna be the Emu Oil. Emu Oil contains linoleic acid, 20-30% of its whole consistency, and this linoleic acid was proven to inhibit the bad prostaglandin, which was found in big amounts in very unhealthy and receded thinning follicles. Emu oil helps to build more of the good prostaglandin, which was found in very healthy and thick follicles. On the contrary, prostaglandin is a lipid compound. The good prostaglandin, PGE2, is found in the healthy hair, while the PGD2 prostaglandin, which is the bad prostaglandin, was found in very unhealthy and thinning hair. And besides that, there was one study which mixed up the emu oil solution together with the foamable minoxidil solution, and they compared it to this minoxidil 5% solution that you can buy. It's FDA approved. And what they found out is that this adapted formulation of minoxidil and emu oil exhibited greater number of hair follicles in anagen phase than just the normal minoxidil solution, 5% or 2%. Honorable to mention here is the argan oil as well, which consists of linoleic acid as well, even more linoleic acid than the emu oil, which will help to build the good prostaglandin and will help to inhibit the bad prostaglandin. So this is another great ingredient to be looking for. Number 7 is gonna be silica. Silica is a great source of bioavailable silicon, trace minerals like calcium and magnesium. Another great thing about silica is that silicon actually promotes the collagen synthesis. And you know that collagen is another great non-essential amino acid, which is very important for the healthy skin, healthy hair. It actually rebuilds the dermis underneath your scalp, but not just underneath your scalp, but your skin, your face. So silicone helps synthesize more collagen, which is very good. And here's one study where people took a supplement. This is nothing else than one another bioavailable form of silicone. They took it for hair for about 9 months. Positive results were obtained in the evaluated hair properties, such as strand resistance to breaking, for example, or even bamboo extract, which contains 70% of silica. So this is another great substance to be looking for in your anti-hair loss shampoo. The ingredient number 6 to be looking for in your shampoo, in your anti-hair loss shampoo, is gonna be jojoba oil. It is rich in vitamin E and vitamin A. It just helps you with dry scalp, helps with dandruff. And there was one study on mice which was comparing jojoba oil, peppermint oil, and minoxidil. Jojoba oil did very well in this study. It ranked on the third place behind minoxidil and peppermint oil when it comes to hair regrowth after 4 weeks. This study was done on mice, unfortunately, and not on human beings. There is not so much research on jojoba oil when it comes to hair growth and hair loss besides this one study, but it is a great oil which shouldn't be missing in the list of ingredients on your anti-hair loss shampoo. The top 5 is gonna be the peppermint oil, which was actually studied together with jojoba oil and minoxidil, and peppermint oil actually ranked better than minoxidil when it comes to hair regrowth after 4 weeks. It was observed by mice, again, unfortunately, not people. The ingredient number 4 to be watching for in your anti-hair loss shampoo is gonna be caffeine. If you don't know anything about how caffeine influences the hair growth, make sure you check out this video here, because this is the video I made on how caffeine helps with hair growth. So make sure you check it out in depth if you want to know something more about that. But just very briefly here, caffeine enhances the IGF-1 insulin-like growth factor protein expression, especially in your hair follicles, right? So it makes your hair follicles produce more protein, which is great. So remember, we were talking about coconut oil, how it is preserving the proteins in your hair, and what caffeine does, it actually enhances even more production of protein within your hair follicle. Ingredient number 3 to be watching for in your anti-hair loss shampoo is gonna be the castor oil or ricinoleic acid. And ricinoleic acid makes up like 70% of the whole castor oil consistency. And you know now that there is a good and bad prostaglandin. What ricinoleic acid does, again, it helps to create more of the PGE2, good prostaglandin, which was found in very healthy and thick hair follicles on our scalp. So another great ingredient to look for in your anti-hair loss shampoo, honorable to mention, is ginger or any kind of ginger extract. Ginger helps to inhibit the bad prostaglandin PGD2 and helps to build more of the good prostaglandin, which again was found in very healthy hair. The ingredient number 2 is gonna be onion or onion extract. There were again one study where people topically applied onion juice or onion extract. At 4 weeks, hair regrowth was seen in 17 patients, which was like 70% of the group. And at 6 weeks, the hair growth was observed 86% of whole group. Onions are very well known for their antifungal, anti-inflammatory, and antibacterial properties, especially on your scalp. They contain a lot of sulfur, which helps to cleanse and helps the blood flowing into your scalp, into your hair follicles. So if you eat onions or you apply any topical liquid out of onions, there's a high chance that you will experience at least some hair growth benefits. The natural ingredient number 1 is gonna be pumpkin seeds or pumpkin seed oil or pumpkin seed extract. Pumpkin seeds contain a beta-sitosterol, which is an inhibitor of 5-alpha reductase, and it acts in a very similar way as finasteride, as you know, very well known FDA approved treatment for men with enlarged prostate and androgenic alopecia, because it blocks the conversion from testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. So pumpkin seed extract is one of the best substances to have in your shampoo, in your anti-hair loss shampoo. Honorable to mention is a substance called ketoconazole, which serves as a DHT blocker as well. It's very effective. Again, there are not many studies on ketoconazole affecting hair loss. However, there are many studies on how ketoconazole affects fungus and dandruff on your scalp. That's why it's actually FDA approved for treating dandruff, and it's not FDA approved for treating hair loss, even though it stops your hair loss very fast. And I'm talking from my own experience. That's why, even though it's not so natural as rosemary oil of a substance, I'm still gonna put it here on this video so you can see, because it's very effective, especially if you're a male. It's been very successful, not in my case, but in many guys' case, in blocking DHT on your scalp. And only by using it after 2-3 weeks, you can already observe like almost total stoppage of your hair loss. Alright, that was it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And if you like this one, make sure you hit that like button below, because there is more videos like this one to come, especially if I get nice positive feedback out of you guys. And before you turn it off, this video wasn't really about buying a perfect hair loss shampoo, because there is nothing like a perfect shampoo out there. This video was about kind of teaching you what ingredients are good for your hair, for your scalp. So if you have your favorite shampoo that you're already using, maybe it smells good, maybe you just like it, you can still add some ingredients from my top 10, like coconut oil, rosemary oil, peppermint oil, if your shampoo doesn't have it yet, to your shampoo, and that way make it more anti-hair loss. So that's one tip at the end I want to leave you with, and we'll see each other in the next video.